What is Office for the Web? It was previously called Office Web Apps before. It is Word, Excel, OneNote, and PowerPoint in your web browser. There's no need to have anything installed locally on your device other than a web browser. It's always up to date with the latest version. It's available on a tablet or mobile device. You also get email through Outlook.com and personal OneDrive. It is not the full version of Office that you get on the desktop. And it is not every Office application. It's only Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and OneNote. So how do you access this? You go to office.com on your web browser and you sign in with your office.com username and password. And I'll be showing this to you in a second in the demo. So here's a demo of web apps. I'll be using an account. It's basically a free account with no license assigned to it. So I'm just gonna open up my browser and I've gone to office.com and I'm gonna hit the sign in button. So I'm not gonna get prompted for my email, phone number or Skype number. If I don't have an account, I can easily create one by clicking this create account button. This will bring me basically what account do I want created with a email address. So if I have, in my case, I'm going to be testing with a Gmail account. So I'm just going to go back and I'm going to sign in with my Gmail account. So we're just going to go back to office.com, hit sign in. I'm not going to get prompted for my password for my account. And hit the sign in button. So it's now brought me into office.com. And I can, as you can see, I have Outlook, OneDrive, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote, Skype, Calendar. So these are the apps I have. If I click all apps, you can see there's Sway as well and Tasks. So I got a few more apps, but I'm just gonna go back to this list here and I'm gonna go to the app launcher in the top here. So this is all the apps. I'm just gonna show you what Excel looks like. So if I click on Excel, very similar to the desktop app experience. I'm just gonna create a new workbook. As you can see, it's creating the workbook in just named it book one. Now it's being saved all the time. Autosave is turned on as part of, so there's no need to manually save the files. They save every few seconds. One of the requirements is that I always am connected to a web browser, so, or connected to an internet connection, so which I am in this case. As you can see, this looks a lot like desktop Excel, and I'll be talking about some of the differences between the web version and the desktop versions of things. But as you can see, I have a home, insert, data tab, review, view. So looks a lot like normal Excel if I want to use a formula. So one of the main things is you have formulas, but they're limited to very basic formulas. As you can see, I have, you know, a lot of formulas here, but it's not the full-fledged version. So so that's Excel. I'm just going to flip over to Word now. I'm going to open that up so you can have a look. Once again, very similar experience, but all being done in the browser. So I can insert, type. I'm just going to close that. So very similar features, insert, layout, references. And once again, I'm signed in just with my free account here. So I want to show you also what OneNote looks like. So I'm just going to open that up. And I have a couple different workbooks here, just my normal workbook, and I've created one called Webinar. And this looks a lot like OneNote that you're used to using on your desktop. My file, I can start a new workbook if I want to. Just click More Notebooks. I can start a new one, create a page. So if I went to Notes, it's a similar. So very similar OneNote experience there you're used to use having. And if I go back to App Launcher, I'm just going to jump into Outlook for a second so you can see what that looks like. I can easily tie my inbox to this. If I go to settings and go to synchronize email, as an example, I could tie a certain, Gmail account to this, or I could leave it, create a default address, pop an IMAP set up. So as you can see, I have a lot of flexibility there in tying email to this. We'll close those tabs. So that's what the product sort of looks like in OneDrive. Again, I can open that up and you can see what OneDrive looks like. OneDrive is an area where you can store files and I can share certain folders with individuals if I wanted to. A few documents here with some folders. So let's go into the differences between the two products, or between the two online version and on-prem version of these apps. So differences online and desktop application. Desktop app is far more feature-rich. Online applications have some limitations. So in the Word app, some of the things that are available on the desktop app and not available on the web are Mail Merge, VBA forms and scripts, Smart Art, captions are all not available on the web app, but are available on the desktop. When we look at Excel differences, basic formulas are available in the web app versus the desktop. There's no VBA or macros available in the web app. What if analysis tools is not available. External references to other workbooks are not available. Protection on workbooks are not available. Slicer and timeline filters are not available. OneNote differences, clipping experiences is not available. Drag and drop section groups is not available. Edit embedded files is not available. And inking tools and template supports are not available as well in the web app. So, for a complete list of what is supported or differences between the two, the web and desktop versions of Excel, Word, OneNote, and PowerPoint, you can go to this URL. So when you're ready to move away from free versions, Microsoft offers, and they have the following plans available, Office 365 plans for business. The basic plan, or basically the starter plan, is Business Essentials for $5 per user per month, which gives you web apps plus Exchange Online, OneDrive for business, SharePoint and Teams. That is this app over here. Being on a shared business plan allows you as a business to collaborate as a team and share documents. It makes things a lot easier to collaborate. If you need added features that are only available in the desktop apps, then moving to one of the business premium plan or the Office 365 business plan, which has the Office apps for the desktop also included, is a good way to go. So, webinar recap. We reviewed what are Office web apps. We reviewed differences between online and desktop apps. We also re reviewed moving to Office 365 paid version.